You can't afford to be without your vehicle. Bobby and his team of professionals at A1 Quick Oil will get you back on the road fast and with the job done right. All technicians are 100% certified. Behind Napa off Highway 51 North, give Bobby a call.
Here at A1, we don't work on cars, we fix them.
Well, the parish council Monday night, and we'll post the video, had a tremendous update from all the utility companies and others in the parish, led by Parish President Robby Miller. And I want to put that aside for a second and talk about the present moment and Nicholas, and just ask the question, is the parish on alert for this approaching, at this time, tropical storm?
Well, as I said at the beginning of my comments about our Hurricane Ida recovery, we're always working to be prepared. We're always aware. We do believe that we're going to only get rain, which is not a good thing to get right now whenever we have so much debris on the ground and so much of our ditches and canals full of the debris. Being only 2 weeks out, as you can imagine, it's a little tough to get it all picked up. But so anybody in the low-lying areas, we're going to ask you to pay close attention to when it does rain and how much it rains, and listen to us. Follow the news, follow you guys to make sure that they know what's going to happen with the rain and how much rain we're going to get. How it flows in our parish will be completely different than our normal knowing what it's going to do. So it will be something we all need to be cautious about.
Because there's so much debris, whether it's the little ditches or the big rivers, no one really knows how the drainage floodplain is going to work.
Right. And look, yes, that's correct. And the idea that the debris is on the ground and they're running hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of loads of debris picked up every day. There's right at 100 trucks running to do that, and probably more than that tomorrow. Each day they add 4 or 5 trucks. So they're probably at 100 or more. And each of those trucks runs 7 or 8, 9 trips a day. So, you know, the debris is being picked up as fast as almost humanly possible. Any more trucks, there would just be a traffic jam of trucks.
But again, this approaching tropical storm, it's not going to be a hurricane. It's not going to be a direct hit. It will give us rain for a couple of days. Unless there's something really unexpected, we don't expect an emergency.
That's true. Other than the fact that, you know, if we get a lot of rain, we don't know where the way they're going to, how it drains differently this time. So it's still something we need to pay attention to and be cautious. I think if we stay in the 4 inch of rain, 4 inches of rain range, that we should be okay.
Because that'll be through Friday.
That's correct. It's not all in an hour.
So you had all the utility companies, everybody up here giving their individual updates, and the one that got the most pushback was Amwaste. The garbage company is admittedly behind, saying 80% of the parish has been picked up, but that's over a 3-week period. So even if that's correct, they're well behind their schedule of pickup.
Well, no doubt about it, and you know, obviously the storm set them behind. There's reports all over the parish that they had missed the week before. Maybe, you know, we're going to believe our citizens. There's a lot of them that said that.
So they could be very behind.
So there's no doubt, and they admittedly said they were very behind. And look, our push isn't about our issue isn't about the guys on the ground. It's not about the local workers here. They're doing everything they can to make it better, to get us caught up. We're trying to emphasize to their management, to their ownership, to understand that you need to put the resources here to get these guys caught up. If not, you'll never catch up. You'll stay behind from now on. So it's a, you know, 1 or 2 time catch up, push hard, get it done. We're going to make sure the landfill's open so that we're not the excuse. And we're going to make sure that our citizens get the service they're supposed to get.
By the way, Amwaste does not have an exclusive franchise, so therefore they theoretically have competition.
They do. Their agreement with the parish is that they will go anywhere in the parish to pick up. They are the preferred, I guess you'd say, contractor for the parish that the council went into, that did the contract a couple of years ago with them. We expect them to follow that and to provide the service that our citizens are paying for. So we're trying to emphasize to upper management to get here to catch up and make it happen. To switch a little bit to the four folks that were here, FEMA, DEMCO, Entergy, and Amwaste. We have other service providers around the parish that do various things for us, but those are the four that we're getting the most phone calls about. Those are the four that our citizens need the most information about. Obviously, FEMA for relief, to make sure that FEMA understands that we need more resources here for our citizens to have contact with, to be able to get set up, to find out what's available to them, and then to have it given to them or reimbursed to them. DEMCO, we have they have 626 customers, our citizens, our friends, our family, that are their customers. They seem to be running way behind and getting caught up. So we want to emphasize the guys on the ground. Again, everything about all these people, the guys on the ground here are working hard. We're trying to get upper management of each of these groups to send more resources to help them, to help the ones on the ground now do their job better. So,
because DEMCO is well behind the other utility companies.
Very much so. And look, DEMCO knows that it's a very difficult terrain. Contract with those folks to be ready to come in. Pre-position them like we have to pre-position many contracts for storms. They know these storms are coming at some point. We are asking their management to get those resources here so that the guys on the ground can get it built back faster. Then we bring Entergy, same thing. We know Entergy's working hard here on the ground. We're just wanting to know what's really going on. Do they have the transformers here? They tell us that they absolutely have them here. They have them here, and they're constantly, they have a good, consistent supply. So there's going to be a big push these last few days to get us close. I think if everybody's telling us the same thing, telling us their actual factual data, which I believe they are, we should see by the end of this week almost everyone with Entergy to be restored. DEMCO may be a different story, but we're hoping that they are bringing in more resources, that their dates that they've given us are far estimates so that they can always, so they can meet them. And then of course AmWaste, we're pushing those guys to bring in, get them fully caught up, so then they have to just run the regular route. If we need to adjust something because there are routes that are hard to get to because debris still there, low wires are still on the road, still some things on the ground that we need to get taken care of, while we work on that, maybe we need to come up with some solution to help them. They come up with a solution, they give us ideas for solutions, we will absolutely review them, research them, go over them, and decide what's best for our citizens to make sure their garbage is picked up, their electricity gets turned on, that they get all the resources from FEMA that they deserve.
What else do you want to share with us?
I think it was a very productive meeting today, and I note that I just want our citizens to know, I hope they realize that every one of these council members, all of our staff, is working diligently with every cell in our body to make sure our citizens are restored as quickly as possible.
Hi, my name is Bobby Danford, and here at A1, we service our customers' needs by providing automotive services to their modern vehicle. 985 presents me with an opportunity to address my fellow businessmen and trading our services for their services. And again, my name is Bobby Danford here at A1, and we do look forward to doing business with you.